Oh, hello. This is Tak Chung from Walk with Tak. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you enjoy this video, please like, subscribe, and share. There's a saying, you love flavor first before you love food. The more I cook, the more I appreciate the power of flavor. And my fast cooking system has four attributes. They're flavor chasing, advanced prepping, stir frying, and template-based cooking. Among the four attributes, flavor chasing is the most important. Because as the saying goes, when we find our best flavor, we become our best cook. Over the years through flavor chasing, and I have tried different seasoning strategies using different kinds of herbs and spices. And then I find one combination work very well. It has almost universal appeal. It works good for both meat and vegetable ingredients. And I call this basic seasoning mix. The key of this seasoning strategy is through the use of an Indian spice box known as the Masala Dabba. Now, in this spice box, it has seven different compartments, all under one cover. So once you open the cover, you have all these seven seasoning agents available to you. And the Masala Dabba provide a tremendous strategic advantage for flavor chasing. Because by having all the different seven seasoning agents available to you all at once, it is more likely for experimenting. Because now you can use different combinations of the seasoning agents that are available to you. But furthermore, you can also use the same combination by changing the ratio of the different seasoning agents can give you an entirely different flavor. First of all, let me explain to you why I choose these seven different seasoning agents to put in the Masala Dabba. In stir frying, the use of natural ingredients is critical for the flavor of the dish. This includes fresh meat, fresh seafood, and fresh vegetables. Therefore, my goal in selecting these seasoning agents is to enhance the natural flavor of the food ingredients rather than overwhelming them. Therefore, the goal in selecting these seasoning agents is to make the dish more savory. After trying out a large number of different seasoning agents, I come down to the selection of these seven that I decided that I would put into my Masala Dabba. The decision of what is good flavor is subjective. And therefore, choosing these seven seasoning agents is personal and individualized. Other people's choices may be quite different from mine. And this is what flavor chasing is all about. And ultimately, what we want to please is our own palate. I'm going to explain to you the reason for my choices, and you can decide whether this will work for you or not. And the first seasoning agent that I choose is the mushroom seasoning. And the mushroom seasoning is actually a seasoning mix. It contains mushroom extract, which is chosen because of their umami flavor. This mushroom extract comes from a collection of dehydrated mushrooms. The primary mushroom that I use for making this mushroom extract is shiitake mushroom. So this mushroom seasoning is manufactured in Taiwan. In addition to the mushroom extract in the form of mushroom powder, it also contains salt and vitamin B and calcium. This mushroom seasoning is rich in umami flavor, and it makes a wonderful substitute of salt. And it contains no MSG. The second seasoning agent that I put into the Masala Dabba is some minced onion flake. I like both the flavor as well as the texture. Again, they are mild. They will improve the complexity of the overall flavor without overwhelming the natural flavor of the food ingredients. And the third ingredient that I put in is some onion powder. This is the time when I want the onion flavor but without the texture of the flakes. And the fourth ingredient I put in is garlic powder. This will give me an option to choose garlic powder over onion powder if I want to. And the fifth seasoning agent that I put in the Masala Dabba is some lemon pepper. I use that as a substitute for pepper, and I also enjoy the lemon flavor that associates with it. Again, this is a seasoning mix. It contains lemon extract, pepper, and also some salt. And therefore, lemon pepper could be used as the substitute for salt. And the sixth seasoning agent that goes into the masala dabba is ginger powder. In certain type of dishes, I really enjoy the flavor of ginger. I don't need a lot of it, just enough to make the overall flavor profile more complex. At the last spot in my masala dabba, I put in the cumin powder. Again, I use cumin powder sparingly. It's used to really to enhance the complexity of the flavor, because I do not want the cumin powder to overwhelm the natural flavor of the ingredients. And so basically, I can divide my seasoning agents in my masala dabba into four categories. The first one is the mushroom seasoning that is designed to enhance the umami flavor of the food ingredients. And the second category, that is to make the dish more savory. And this includes the minced onion flakes, onion powder, and garlic powder. The seasoning agents in both of these categories are relatively mild, and I can use quite a bit of it without having problems that they will overwhelm the natural ingredients of the dish. And the third category is the lemon pepper. And the final category is the cumin powder and ginger powder. These three ingredients have strong taste and aroma, and I need to use them sparingly because they can easily overwhelm the natural flavor of the food ingredients. The masala dabba turned out to be an excellent platform for me to experiment with these seasoning agents. I have learned to use different combinations as well as using different ratios. After repeated experimentation, I discovered there are one formula turned out to be almost universally pleasing for most food ingredients, whether it is seafood, meat, or vegetables. And I call this the basic seasoning mix. I can use this in stir-frying for vegetables, for seafood, and meat. I also use it when I want to marinate meat and seafood. It is great for using in stir-frying because it forms the foundation for other flavor that I'm going to build upon it. I find it particularly good for chicken as well as for shrimp. I would not use it for salmon because salmon already has a very strong flavor. But it is great for whitefish, such as bluegill, smallmouth bass, crappie, and tilapia. For the whitefish, I usually mix it with cornstarch to coat them, and this will create a light, crispy breading. This seasoning is especially good for eggs. You can use it for scrambled eggs, egg omelette, or scramblet, which is a version of stir-fried egg that is a cross between omelette and scrambled eggs. When you're making a soup, this seasoning mix is also excellent to serve as a soup base. Anytime when you need for the soup stock, whether it's chicken, beef, or vegetable, this basic seasoning mix will do a great job. And when it comes to grilling, I find this seasoning mix does an excellent job, whether this is a hamburger, chicken, or vegetables. I use this seasoning mix in my cooking all the time. It saved me a lot of decisions of what seasoning agents to add because this will create the type of flavor that I want. I have used this seasoning mix in my cooking classes and my students really enjoy it, and I make it available for them to purchase. And many of the people online also ask me where they can purchase this seasoning mix, and this is the reason that now I am making it available on Amazon. I still use my masala dabba when I have a need to further fine-tune the flavor of a dish. However, most of the time, I use this basic seasoning mix because it saved me time. And so for the sake of efficiency, this basic seasoning mix really does its job. I post a video each day to help you make home cooking practical, efficient, creative, and fun. If you'd like to learn more about my fast cooking system, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. So keep on cooking. I will see you tomorrow.